Actually, I'm not quite ready.
Oh.
I mean, I will be in like 20 seconds. Oh. I just gotta go run to the bathroom. Oh, you got me on film.
Yeah.
Even doctors gotta go number one and two from time to time. A little piddle. Am I right?
You're very right.
That's right.
Good luck, Dad. Everything come out okay?
I washed, yes. Everything went fine.
Well, that's good to know.
I've got a mom who's worried about her son's throat. We're gonna let her tell us.
Hello.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
We're good. How are you
doing? You brought your bunny with you today. That is a really nice looking bunny. Does a bunny go cock-a-doodle-doo? No.
Is his name Bun Bun?
Bun Bun. That's such a good name. Tell us, what's going on?
So he seems to be snoring quite a bit at night. And yeah. He has what look like really large inflamed tonsils, but all the time. And I kind of thought as he got older, maybe the space would open up on its own. But that definitely doesn't seem to be the case.
Gotcha.
And now he's snoring a lot at night and kind of like craning his neck up. So it seems like he's trying to open
when
up.
When he's asleep,
tonsils.
You see him doing that?
Yeah, like he'll start to move his head up and then every once in a while I'll hear him catch his breath.
I know some people when they obstruct, they'll like snore. Does he snore?
He snores.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you'll hear that.
Yes.
Kind of stuff, is that what he's doing?
Exactly.
There it is, yay. You did it. There it is. Perfect.
We're looking at his little uvula. It hangs down. And then when he finally gagged, and we got a decent look, these were his tonsils. They're what you would call about a 3+. When they get to 4+, they're actually almost touching, right? So it looks like a baseball. That would be 4+. He's definitely not 4+. He's somewhere between 3+ and maybe a little bit less than that. He's got some airway, but I imagine when he's if he's sleeping on his back and relaxing, the tonsils will kind of collapse in on themselves and he's obstructing. When you're a teenager, your throat's gonna be 1.5 times as big. And those 3+ tonsils are now the same size. Let's just say they don't get any bigger. But look at the difference in airway.
Massive.
Massive difference. So we can just hang in there. He will also outgrow this problem. So what things could we possibly do that might lower the size of these tonsils so that we don't have to go to surgery? I would say the number one thing would be to see if there's any foods in his world, in his diet, that are triggering inflammation.
Okay.
Does he sleep on his back?
Yeah. He sleeps on his back or he'll sleep like kind of back
sideways.
To side.
If we can teach him to sleep on his side, maybe a little pillow between his legs, and it won't obstruct as much. This is integrative medicine. Food sensitivity testing is IgG testing for about 100 different foods. I have had incredible luck with identifying foods that are triggering an inflammatory immune response, removing them from the diet, and for sure eczema goes away if you have eczema, which is dry skin, but it can also help other inflammatory conditions, whether it's a GI inflammation, brain fog, or perhaps his tonsils. So we're gonna give it a whirl, see if we can avoid tonsillectomy. You did a good job. Yeah! Hey guys, thanks for watching. Big thumbs up for an amazing family that's helping us go on this journey of figuring out what's going on with your tonsils.